I look back, I got a fuego!
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cooling, all shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel-Air." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said, "I might as well kick it." First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of a champagne glass. Is this what the people of Bel-Air living like? This might be alright. But wait, I hear the prissy bourgeois and all that. Is this the type of place that they just send this cool cat? I don't think so. I'll see when I get there. I hope they're prepared for the Prince of Bel-Air. The plane landed and when I came out, there was a dude look like a cop standing there with my name out. I ain't trying to get arrested yet, I just got here. I sprang with the quickness like lightning disappeared. I whistled for a cab and when it came near, the license plate said fresh and it had dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it, yo, home's the Bel-Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8 and I yelled to the cabbie, "Yo, home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel-Air.
Arnold! bed, go run and tell your homeboys and homegirls it's time for Keenan and Kel. To keep you laughing in the afternoon, so don't touch that dial on Read the Room. Cause they always in the summer, no frontin' and you don't wanna miss it. It's double K like through the good way. It's Keenan and Kel, I should've said Kel and Keenan. And you gotta watch Keenan, cause Keenan be scheming with a plan or a plot to make it to the top, but they kinda in the middle, cause they always getting caught. This ain't the Hardy Boys or a Nancy Drew mystery. It's just Keenan and Kel in your vicinity, like Siegfried and Roy, Abbott and Costello, Magic and Kareem, or Penn and Teller. Somebody's in trouble, oh here go, oh Nick